everyone. Today we are checking out the Polaroid Go. Is it really worth it? Well, I'm not really sure either. So let's find out together and just see what the Polaroid Go is all about. Also, hi, my name is Afra. Welcome to my channel. If you end up finding this video helpful or not helpful, please let me know in the comments so I'll know. I am planning to make this a very simple video, so be sure to check out the timestamps in the description below so you can just get the information that you need. So we'll do an unboxing, we'll have a little demo tryout session in different lighting so we can see how the pictures turn out, and then we'll try out some of the features that makes this camera unique. I finally have some weekend plans, so I will be taking this camera and we'll just give it a go, give the Polaroid Go a go, and see what we end up with. Right, let's do this. Okay, let's first start with an unboxing. I actually did the actual unboxing of the box that came in on my TikTok, so here's a clip of that. I wanted to get straight to the actual contents of the package on my YouTube channel. Okay, so here's what came with the Polaroid Go. Let's first check out the actual camera and see what it's like. As you can see, it's about the size of my hand, so it's true, it is very small. Some of the other things the package came with was a user manual and a pack of cute stickers that had a very retro feel to it. Little things like this make me so happy. And it also came with a strap and a charger. Also, I bought the starter set because the Polaroid Go doesn't come with film for some reason, so the starter set came with 2 packs of film. And each pack came with little double-sided stickers to use on her Polaroid, which was a nice little touch. And here comes my first fail. So I put the film pack in my camera and I kept pulling at what I thought was the photo, but apparently this is like the protective so the sun or light doesn't damage the photo as it comes out. So yeah, don't pull at it. Just kind of untuck it like this and we are good to go. Okay, now let's take this Polaroid Go out and see what it can do. The very first photo I took was a selfie. This is kind of embarrassing for me, but the camera has a little mirror on it, so this is one of the features that makes the Polaroid Go so appealing, so I had to try it out. And here's how my Polaroid selfie turned out. I'll let you be the judge of how you think these photos turned out, but I'll let you know about the process and the lighting as we go. Okay, let's see how things change now that we have natural lighting on our side. It was a clear day and the sun was shining bright on these flowers, so I had to give it a try. And here's how it turned out. Not bad. So my plans for this weekend was going to a BTS cup sleeve event, which was just so cute and the perfect opportunity to take some Polaroids. They had BTS themed drinks. The purple drink was named Microcosmos and the pink was named Boy With Love. You guys, how cute is that? So of course, I took a Polaroid of this. Note the lighting. We were indoors, but there were some windows near us, so the lighting looked like this. And here's how the Polaroid turned out. I wish I held my camera just a little bit higher because it looks like the table became in focus, so learn this from me. Make sure your object is right in the middle. At the back of the restaurant, there was this cool neon sign. I had really, really high hopes for this one, but I think I made the mistake of not turning off the flash, which I completely forgot to consider because there were so many people around me and I felt so awkward. But anyways, the flash made the photo look like this. After the BTS event, we went to Party City to run some errands. I thought this hallway that was color coordinated with party supplies was so cute and dreamy. It honestly felt magical to walk in. Am I like romanticizing Party City? Like I need, okay, let me hold back. But for some reason, my camera really malfunctioned on me. I kept pressing the shutter button to take the Polaroid, but it just wouldn't take the picture. I struggled there for like a good 5 minutes. So when I finally got it to work, I was moving my Polaroid Go and captured this photo. I mean, the Polaroid isn't bad. It's kind of like moody or Tumblr grungy, but I was stressing out because each pack only comes with 8 Polaroids and I didn't want to waste any. And of course, with the bad Party City luck that I was having, I think I may have accidentally captured a double exposure photo with all the buttons I was pressing. So my guess is that when I was pressing all these buttons trying to fix my camera, that it took a picture of the fluorescent lighting above on the ceiling, and then it also took a picture of the hallway. So yeah, I think that probably explains like the white box in the center. So yeah, I was kind of disappointed because I imagined my Polaroid to be super colorful and bright, just like how it looked like in real life, but I guess that is life, right? Speaking of which, another feature that makes the Polaroid Go so unique is the double exposure feature. So let's give it a real try. So in my room, I wanted to layer on a photo of my green clock and my Love Yourself poster. So to do the double exposure, the instructions are to double click the flash button and the number one should appear to represent the first image. Again, I struggled so hard because I kept clicking the shutter button to capture and it just wasn't happening. After some time, it finally went through and the number two appeared, so I took my second shot. So here's how it turned out. As you can see, it didn't really turn out too well, and I think it's because I had my flash on. So I wanted to try turning off the flash, and I did my first photo, but then I didn't realize that you have to turn off the flash again for the second frame. So I think it pretty much turned out the same as the first, because maybe the flash bounced back on my picture frame and it just reflected. I have no idea, but yeah. And finally, I wanted to try the Polaroid Go at nighttime. I was basic and took a picture of this stop sign. You guys, I really didn't think the flash would mess this one up, especially because it was at night, but maybe because the stop sign is reflective, this photo also turned out kind of exposed. But it's not a complete fail. So the Polaroid Go, is it worth it? If I had to choose, I would say, drumroll please. No, it's not worth it. And here's why. It's not a simple camera to make the most out of it with all its features. The Polaroid Go is $110 for the starter set. Compared to its competitor, the Instax is like $50 to $60. And you can buy really cool value packs that are out there like this with cool frames and stickers that really makes the most out of the Instax. So I think the Polaroid Go comes with a lot of cool features like the double exposure and the self timer, which I wasn't able to show in this video. But all the features it has is living in the flash button, like clicking twice for exposure, holding down for timer, and then of course on and off flash. If you aren't careful, you can really mess up your photos just like I did. I guess what I'm trying to say is if you have the patience with time and with your wallet, then the Polaroid Go isn't that bad. Like, trust me, I wanted to make this review so sparkly and fun to encourage people to buy this small, cute Polaroid, but I can't lie. So if you're a beginner or you're looking for a friendlier option, I would reconsider buying the Polaroid Go. And who knows, maybe I'll change my mind once I really learn how to use this camera and get confident in it. But this is my first impression review thing, and I just wanted to share with anyone watching so they can get a real understanding on what the Polaroid Go is like. So what do you think? Are you considering buying the Polaroid Go? Having similar experiences if you already bought one? I want to know, so make sure you comment your thoughts on this video. If you found this video helpful in any way, it would mean so much if you subscribed. Thank you so much. Until next time, stay healthy and happy, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!